You're listening to the audio production of So Much to Celebrate, Entertaining the Ones You Love the Whole Year Through by Katie Jacobs, published by Thomas Nelson and read by Nan Kelley.
Dedication to my grandmother, Honey Mama, for her love, to my mother for her laughter, and to my daughter, Emmeline, who makes every day worth celebrating. Introduction. I have so much to be thankful for. There is so much to celebrate. Living life with joy and gratitude alongside the people you love makes every day special and worthy of celebration. Impromptu barefoot in the kitchen dance parties, a three-tier chocolate cake just because it's Tuesday, and cotton candy-topped milkshakes to mark the end of summer vacation transform seemingly ordinary moments into the essential threads that weave together the fiber of who we are. So many of my favorite and profoundly pivotal memories happened in the kitchen or around the dinner table. Eating steak and baked potatoes at the long farm table on the porch of our family's lake house. The Thanksgiving meal overflowing on my mom's kitchen island. Pot roast served in my grandmother's elegant Williamsburg dining room. Pizza on the floor of my first apartment. So much of my life has centered around food and sharing meals with family and friends. My grandmother taught me how to set a table, and my mother taught me how to arrange flowers. But more importantly, they taught me the art of celebrating, how to create meaningful, unfussy gatherings, not without effort, but carried out with relative ease, that create lasting memories with the ones you love. Now that I am a mom, I realize more and more that time is fleeting. It forces me to stop, take a breath, and remember how grateful I am that I have so much to celebrate. I want to always take the time to make loved ones feel special and create extraordinary celebrations to foster memories that will last a lifetime. I set out to create a book that is not only beautiful, but is also a guide to creating lifelong memories with family and friends. Inspiration to encourage more parties, more togetherness, more celebrations. It is my hope that the family suppers, holiday parties, and informal gatherings found in this book will inspire you to live a little more life together with the ones you love. Katie. Spring. The arrival of spring's first sun-kissed days beg to be celebrated. Warmer weather ushers out the long, cold days of winter, and sunny days are a welcome friend that everyone rejoices in. The season's clean slate and fresh blooms inspire parties featuring lighter menus and sunny decor. Tablescapes displaying natural elements bring the outdoors in, showcasing the earth's beautiful bounty. There's nothing more blissful than enjoying the first flush of lovely weather with the ones you love. My favorite way to spend a springtime afternoon is with my daughter, Emmeline, at the botanical gardens, giggling and watching the geese as we sit on a vintage quilt laid in the grass. We love to pack a picnic of simple sandwiches, fresh fruit, and lemonade, and bask in the sunlight for as long as possible. Whether you're enjoying an intimate outdoor picnic for two or a porchside dinner party for 10, spring's cheerful, sun-filled days are reason enough to celebrate. Fairy Tale Fern White Linen Luncheon. Sometimes inspiration comes in the most unexpected places. Last spring, I toured a local design show house and noticed that nearly every designer had incorporated beautiful, lush green ferns into their spaces. Not only is greenery a simple way to breathe life into an interior, but for me, it sparked the idea for a fresh and simple spring luncheon. Invite your girlfriends for a chic ladies' luncheon featuring relaxed white linens, fern centerpieces, and a delicate lunch to celebrate the new growth that will soon be breathing life into the long, cold days of the past winter season. Get the look. I always try to host events that are both elegant and relaxed. In lieu of traditional plates, I used wooden paddles to serve soup and sandwiches alongside petite white macaroons. Crystal candlesticks with long white tapers peeked through lush ferns planted in a collection of vintage white pitchers. And champagne was served in hand-blown glass flutes. Everyone loved the watercolor and calligraphed place cards that were attached to fern branches, casually draped across each place setting. Think outside the box. When throwing a party like this one at your home, don't be afraid to rearrange a room or two to achieve the desired look. Change up your seating by adding a bench. Don't worry about silverware and glasses matching perfectly, and plant ferns in white containers that you already have. Pitchers and colanders make for elegant and unexpected centerpieces. Switching out art or having something new made specifically for the affair will take your party to the next level. I splurged and commissioned the watercolor and calligraphy painting Over the River and Through the Woods to use for the invitations. Then I framed the painting and placed it above the fireplace for the party. The menu. While the decor often takes center stage, the food is what guests will really remember. Be sure to coordinate your offerings with the theme of the event. Zucchini soup with creme fraiche and cilantro, cucumber tea sandwiches with lemon and dill, vanilla bean macaroons, and homemade coconut cake not only mimic the green and white decor, but will also leave your guests gushing. Paired with cucumber water, fresh green tea with mint, and champagne, toasts will abound. Enjoy the party. Luncheon items are super simple to make ahead. I like to set the table in advance with plates and bowls, and then during the party, when everyone is seated, I serve the warm soup to each guest by pouring it out of a pitcher. Tea sandwiches can be made the morning of, and a cake the day before. Put out beautiful glass pitchers filled with tea and water so guests can help themselves. Make it ahead. Prepare or pick up soup up to 2 days in advance and reheat it on the stove the day of the party. Coconut cake. This recipe has become a year-round dessert that always feels appropriate for any function, snowy in the winter and light in the spring. At our wedding, in lieu of a traditional wedding cake, my husband Brent and I chose 14 different 9-inch round cakes in various flavors. Each cake honored a member of our immediate family and was displayed on a tree stump or antique cake stand. The bride and groom's cake was a coconut cake that was adorned with my grandparents' antique cake topper. This cake, with cream cheese icing and a hint of almond extract, always takes me back to our wedding day. 1 1/2 cups, 3 sticks, unsalted butter, softened. 2 cups sugar. 5 large eggs, room temperature. 1 1/2 teaspoons pure vanilla extract. 1 1/2 teaspoons pure almond extract. 3 cups all-purpose flour. 1 teaspoon baking powder. 1/2 teaspoon baking soda. 1/2 teaspoon kosher salt. 1 cup buttermilk. 1 14-ounce package sweetened shredded coconut, divided. Cream cheese icing. 2 8-ounce packages cream cheese, softened. 1 1/2 cups, 3 sticks, unsalted butter, softened. 1 teaspoon pure vanilla extract. 1/4 teaspoon almond extract. 1 1/2 pounds powdered sugar, sifted. Makes one cake, approximately 12 servings. Number 1, preheat the oven to 350 degrees. Butter and flour 3 9-inch round cake pans. Number 2, in the bowl of an electric mixer fitted with the paddle attachment, cream the butter and sugar on high speed until light and fluffy, about 5 minutes. With the mixer on low speed, add the eggs, one at a time, scraping down the bowl after each addition. Add the vanilla and almond extracts and mix until just incorporated. Number 3, in a separate bowl, sift together the flour, baking powder, baking soda, and salt. In 3 parts, alternately add the flour mixture and the buttermilk to the batter, beginning and ending with the flour mixture. Mix until just combined. Fold in 7 ounces of the coconut. Number 4. Divide the batter evenly among 3 pans. Bake, rotating the pans halfway through, until golden brown and a cake tester inserted into the center comes out clean, about 25 to 35 minutes. Number 5. Transfer the pans to a wire rack. Once the cakes are cooled, invert them onto the racks, then re-invert top side up. Cool completely. While the cakes are cooling, make the icing. Number 6. To make the cream cheese icing, in the bowl of an electric mixer fitted with the paddle attachment, on low speed, cream together the cream cheese, butter, vanilla, and almond extract. Add the powdered sugar and mix until smooth. Number 7. To assemble the cake, place the first layer on a serving platter. Using an offset spatula, spread the top with 1/4 inch of icing. Top with the second layer, another 1/4 inch of icing, and then the third layer. Ice the sides and top of the cake with the remaining icing and cover with the remaining coconut. Make it ahead. Make this cake the day before serving and store it in the refrigerator. Let it come to room temperature before serving. Breakfast in bed. Exceptional days like birthdays and Mother's Day require special attention. There's nothing like making breakfast in bed to show someone just how much you love him or her. It's a beautiful break from the regular routine and the perfect way to start a day of celebration. My family loves to curl up in bed together. We usually pile in and watch a movie, or if it's someone's birthday, we all jump in together in our PJs and open early morning gifts. On Mother's Day, I'm treated to breakfast in bed that we all end up sharing. Since I'm the one who loves to cook in our house, I usually give my husband a little help by making pancake batter ahead of time so it's ready and waiting in the fridge for him. I've also been known to set out a breakfast tray the night before as a hint. Perfect pancakes. Make this pancake batter ahead of time and store it in the refrigerator so it's ready to pour on the griddle first thing in the morning. You can also cook up the pancakes, let them cool, and freeze them. That way, it's easy for little hands to pop them in the toaster to heat up for a special breakfast. 2 cups all-purpose flour. 1 3/4 teaspoons baking powder. 1/3 cup sugar. 1/2 teaspoon coarse salt. 3 large eggs, separated. 1 1/2 cups whole milk. 6 tablespoons unsalted butter, melted, plus 1 teaspoon for cooking. 1/2 teaspoon pure vanilla extract. Fresh fruit, optional. Maple syrup. Makes approximately 18 pancakes. Number 1. Sift the flour, baking powder, sugar, and salt in a large bowl. Number 2. In a medium bowl, whisk together the egg yolks, milk, 6 tablespoons butter, and vanilla until combined. Whisk the yolk mixture into the flour mixture until just combined. The batter will be slightly lumpy. Number 3. Place the egg whites in the bowl of an electric mixer fitted with the whisk attachment and whisk until medium peaks form. Mix 1/2 the egg whites into the batter with a rubber spatula. Gently fold in the remaining whites. The egg whites should not be fully incorporated into the batter. Store the batter in the refrigerator in an airtight container until ready to use, or use it immediately. Number 4. To cook the pancakes, heat a griddle until hot, about 350 to 375 degrees. Add the remaining butter to the hot griddle. Add 1/4 cup of the pancake batter and let it set. When bubbles begin to form, lift the pancake. If it's golden brown, turn it over. Cook until golden brown on the remaining side. Number 5. Transfer the cooked pancake to a plate and keep it warm. Repeat the process with the remaining batter. Garnish with fresh fruit and serve warm with maple syrup. Make it ahead. Make this batter up to a day in advance and store it in the refrigerator in an airtight container. You can also freeze the cooked pancakes by letting them cool completely and placing them in individual freezer bags in the freezer. To cook the frozen pancakes, place them in a toaster until warm through. Easter egg hunt. Ask me what my favorite holiday is, and Easter is my immediate reply. When I was a little girl, I always looked.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.